Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. So in this video, I am going to implement linear search. So if you want to watch its algorithm, so you can go to description of this video and there you will find a link of playlist. So you can watch its algorithmic implementation. So right now I'm going to implement the code so that you can understand how linear search works. So first of all, I'm going to include a header file. Now I'm going to define a method. So its name is lsearch, that is linear search. Then here it will be receiving an array, its size and the item that we are going to search. Now I'm going to declare one variable as I, variable loc, and I'm initializing it with -1. Now I'm going to implement a loop. So loop will be starting from 0. It will repeat till this condition is true, that is I less than n, then I plus plus. Now inside this loop, I'm going to apply if condition. So I need to check a of I with item. So if a of I is equals to item, it means the number is available in the array. So I can assign value of I into loc and I can apply break, right? And when this loop will be completing, so I'm going to return value of loc. So if item is available in the array, so its location will be available into loc variable. Otherwise, loc will be having -1, right? Now after its linear search function definition, now I'm going to define main function. So inside main function, I am declaring an array. Item variable. So first I'm going to print a message for user. So enter size of array. I'm going to read this size from user. So right now it is a static array. You can also create array dynamically using malloc function. So initially size of array is 20, but through this printf scanf, I'm going to read the size, like actually how many elements user want to store. So that will be available into n. Now I'm going to apply a loop. So this loop will repeat n times. And inside this loop, I'm going to write printf statement. So enter number. Then scanf %d and %a of I. So this way, using this for loop, all the numbers will be stored into this array. Now I am going to read the number that we are going to search in the array. So enter the number you want to search. So again scanf. And number will be stored into item. So now here I need to call that linear search function. So I'm going to declare one more variable, that is loc. And here I'm going to call that function. So name of function is lsearch, passing array size and item that we are going to search. And the returned value will be stored into loc. Now I need to check if loc not equals to -1, right? So if loc not equals to -1, it means number is found. So we can write printf found at %d position, and I'm printing loc plus 1. Why plus 1? Because in case of C programming, indexes are starting from 0. So let's say your element is available on first position, so loc will be containing 0. But we want to print the location as 1. So loc plus 1 should be printed, right? Then else, I can write printf number is not found. So this way the code is completely implemented and ready to execute. So I'm going to save this code. So I'm saving it as linearsearch.c. Now I'm going to compile and run. So it is throwing an error. So here n is not declared, so I'm declaring it. I is also not declared, so I'm declaring it as well. Yeah, now it is executed. So I'm entering the size as 5. Numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The number you want to search, I am entering 4. So you can see found at 4th position. So it is working well. Again, I am going to execute this code. And again, I am entering 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this time I am going to search 6. So you can see number is not found. So this way, the code of linear search is working perfectly. So this is the complete code implementation with the help of integrated development environment that is in front of you. And if you want to understand the logic with the help of classroom teaching, so those playlist links are available in the description of this video. So both algorithm implementation and the implementation of this code and explanation in classroom teaching. So you can watch that and you can understand it well. So I hope you understood how this code is working. Thank you for watching this video.